Hey guys, it's Phil from smilinggardener.com, and as you can see behind me, I am back in my garden. I have no idea why we decided to come back in mid-April when it's like, you can see my breath. It's a little above freezing here. It was like 80 degrees every day in Peru. I think next time maybe we'll come back in late April, but it's actually, we're just having a cold spell here and a wet spell. I'm really, really happy to be home and back in the garden. Maybe it'll be a couple weeks before I can get in there, but that's okay. If you've been following along in the last month or so, you know that I'm in the process of creating a series of lessons. It's like a free online course I'm putting together that's just, it's really going to be great. I haven't been able to make the videos yet because I was in Peru, and it turns out I probably won't start making them for a couple weeks because it's just too cold out here. And what I want to do with these videos is actually make them really good and spend a while on them, so I got to wait till it's a little warmer before I do that. What I'm talking about today, though, is soil testing. I'll make a video for you in a couple of weeks when I'm going to be in Chicago next weekend. So after that, I'll get back in the garden and make some videos. Today, it's soil testing. So the reason you want a soil test is because you want to know which fertilizers to use. A lot of people will go to the garden center and buy NPK fertilizers or green sand or dolomite lime. Dolomite lime has calcium and magnesium. Green sand has potassium. But the problem is you don't know if you need those things, and maybe they're going to cause more problems in your soil than benefits, because they can, if you already have enough, there can be issues there. So that's when we soil test. A couple of weeks I'm going to show you how to do it. For now you can read on below. I write about how to do it and which soil labs I like to use. And that's all for now. Maybe next week I'll make a video for you from the busy streets of Chicago. And then I can't wait to get back in this garden and make some gardening videos for you. So that is all for this week.